today I am going through different things that we do for one of our clients who is in the travel agent industry. So this essentially is going to be kind of like a media walkthrough for them, just to give you an idea of the kinds of things that we do in the travel industry. And there are a lot of different ways this could translate to different industries. And it's also important to note that travel is not the only industry we work with. We're very multifaceted to our approach, and we don't work just simply with the travel industry. But that being said, our strategy is going to translate well to obviously travel, anything that has to do, I believe, with a public front-facing business owner, someone that they are the face of their brand, and it involves connecting with people and creating quotes or some kind of plan after you've gotten a chance to get to know people. So I would say more service-based businesses will benefit from this approach in particular that I'm going to go over today. So we're going to go over the client's website, some of the things that we did for their branding, their social media, and we're also going to talk a little bit about coaching and consulting that we do with them as well. So we're going to kind of hit on all cylinders, so I'm excited to get in here. This walkthrough, if you guys have any questions, make sure that you drop a comment. And definitely, we really appreciate you hitting that subscribe button, that follow button as well, if you can. Make sure that when you're subscribing on YouTube, you click on get all notifications, because if it's just a simple default, more than likely, you're not going to see a lot of content from us. YouTube is just one of those things that you have to tell it, show me notifications, hit that notification bell. Otherwise, you just really don't come up often on the newsfeed. So it would help us greatly. Thank you so much. Shameless plug out of the way. All right. So let's first talk about the company itself, a little bit of a background on this client. So James Carpenter Travel has been a client with us for a very long time. I would say maybe at least 5 years, possibly more. We started with them before they even had a business. So they launched their business with us. And this is their second or third iteration of their site. So as we've grown in scope, they've grown in scope. And at a certain point, we decided to migrate their website to WordPress. And WordPress is a great platform because it allows us to have an infinite amount of possibilities with what we can do. And it tends to be more friendly to Google search than other platforms for sure. So we have our website on WordPress. Most of our clients are on WordPress. And the ones who are not, it's very small exceptions like Shopify or something like that. It's mostly just our e-commerce clients that are using something other than WordPress. But if you're an e-commerce client, WordPress will still work really well for you. So I would highly recommend that if you're looking to change website providers or you're looking to start a new website. So this client sells travel packages. He basically custom makes things for you. So if you're looking for a cruise or, you know, airfare, things like that, hotels, even rideshare, things like that, he helps you organize those things. And he has a discount through different affiliates. Now, more recently, this has just came up. He's also offering consulting in some of these areas. So before, you used to go to him when you were ready to set these things up. And you basically just kind of used his discount and you did the whole setup process for your travel experience on your own. Maybe he would throw in some guidance here or there. Now he's offering coaching. So let's say, you know, for the sake of argument, you own a business and you travel a lot for, you know, for things that you do in the company. And, you know, you don't always want to hire a travel agent to set it up for you. You want to learn, you know, how to access these discounts. So maybe you'll go to him for some advice on how to do that and how to travel efficiently, you know. Or let's say you have a honeymoon, right? And there's a lot of different things to plan, a lot of people to coordinate. It can seem very overwhelming. And just watching one or two YouTube videos or even hours of YouTube videos might not be enough for you to put all those pieces together. And as a consultant, a travel expert, he can point you in the right direction, tell you exactly what you need to do, or he can set up that travel experience for you. And all you simply have to do is pay him for his time to do that. You don't have to worry about a thing. So he's just continued to expand and grow over the years with the scope of work that he does, which is really awesome to see. And something worth noting, because you might be out there watching this, or maybe you're in the travel industry or something else, and you're saying to yourself, well, I can't offer all these things. I'm just starting out, or it seems overwhelming to me. Just start out with you know, some of these things that we talked about, and you can always expand later. Right? That's the beauty of this and working with us at COS Marketing Agency is you can start out with a simple website and search engine plan, and it can blossom into something else later. Or you can start out going all in. It's really up to you. What can you afford? And also what your expectations are. What are your goals and how fast are you trying to get there? Mm-hmm. So you'll see when we land on his site, he's got an immediate call to action and information about him and his services, a prompt to contact. We don't want them to go all the way to the bottom of the page before seeing his contact information. We want to make this as easy as possible, right? And we have a contact form, different ways to connect with him. And of course, he's pictured in the majority of his marketing because it's called James Carpenter Travel, not travel, whatever here today. It's specifically James Carpenter Travel. So he is very much the front face of the brand. So that's why I was saying this strategy is going to work a lot better for you if you are also front facing with your brand, kind of like we are. You probably have seen some of our stuff at COS Marketing Agency. You've probably seen me or someone else's face on my team in our marketing. And there's a reason for that. The reason is people like to connect with other people. And I know we are in the AI age, and don't get me wrong, I use AI and I think it has its usefulness, but people want to connect with other people, and it means something when you are contacting James Carpenter Travel and James Carpenter himself will pick up. It shows a different level of commitment and respect for your brand. I really do believe that. And studies will show most people do connect with brands better that way. Doesn't mean it's necessarily going to guarantee a sale, but it helps. Statistically, it just gives you a better chance, right? Testimonials are very important for any company, so we make sure to highlight that on their website. And it was where we kind of brag a little bit, right? How much savings he was able to bring his clients, right? How many people he's worked with, things like that. That's where we really get to brag because this particular client, he's been doing this for a long time. Even before we started working together 5 years ago, decades before that, he's been involved in the travel industry one way or the other. He's also a veteran. So we do mention that in his marketing as well. He's very well traveled on his own. So we mentioned the places that he's traveled, his personal experience. Again, a personalized approach to this just makes it a lot more real. And it's going to make you stand out from the crowd because your average company owner, unfortunately, is not taking their marketing seriously enough or is not making it personal. It's just very generic templates, things like that happen, if they're even doing it at all. So just by not doing that and taking a more personalized approach and really trying to imagine you're there talking to the prospect, right? But, you know, on a massive scale, that's what's going to change your mindset. We'll help some of these things fall into place. And of course, if you need guidance along the way, we are here to help you. Obviously, in the footer, you got to have the contact information. We did all the privacy policy information. Everything that you see here top to bottom was created by us, including the social media links, which you always want to link out to social media. It is good for Google as well. They like that connection. So let's check out some more of this site. So we also added in a lot of sections here related to specifically his top destination. So over the course of years, there are certain places that people are just saying they want to go to, they want to get information about. And these are the top places that he sees, but I can make a laundry list of 20 pages or more about different travel destinations. right? These are just like the main ones that people come to him and talk about. Daytona Beach, that's a little bit different. He is based out of Daytona Beach. You can work with people anywhere, but where he's based out of in Daytona Beach is a pretty popular tourist destination. We added that there specifically, partially because of that, but mostly because he's located there. And all of this that you see here is very good for search engine optimization, or SEO. And we do all of his on-page search engine optimization. So what you see here is just the front-facing part. On the back end, we have tags associated with everything, keywords associated with everything that we handpick, not just for his industry, but for his specific audience and his main locations that he surfaces, which if you were, I guess, to, you know, pull up a map or, you know, imagine his radius, it starts out with Daytona. A lot of his followers are there, but then it goes, you know, worldwide. So, you know, he has a very high, very high reach, right? Again, all of it's connected to SEO. Very important to have a background on the client, especially if, you know, they are front facing in this. And as you can see, we featured him in a video, so we added that there. It's another way to, you know, YouTube, like, you know, so a lot of you are going to be watching this on YouTube, right? It's a very, very good way to promote your products and services. As well, little things like that, that pop up and move kind of shows you, or kind of attracts your eye, right? That's part of it. Keeps your attention for longer. They stay and call, wants to ask me like, hey, are we good? All right. And then the contact form, right? Every website, they need a contact form. I'm really shocked and surprised that some of these websites that we see, even in travel, they don't have it. And then the blogs. So part of our on-page search engine optimization plans typically include blogs. Blogs are important for lots of reasons. The most obvious is it's going to create more ways for you to be searchable on Google, right? I mean, at the end of the day, social media is fantastic. I love social media. I've spent a good majority of my career involved in social media marketing, but it has its limitations, just like everything else. Ultimately, the majority of people these days are making purchase decisions on Google, right? So that's something to keep in mind. The more connections that you build on Google, the better off you are. It increases your chances exponentially of getting in front of the right prospects. Nothing's going to guarantee a X amount of sales, you know, but it increases your chances significantly of doing so by having more of those connections on Google. And you want to make those blogs relevant to the industry. You always, always, always want to address problems that your prospects are facing. They're unique problems. Have you ever scrolled through your newsfeed and you're just like looking at these titles and you're like, wait a second, like, it's almost like so-and-so was in your head, right? Because you might be going through an issue and you see a video pop up and it's like, it perfectly addresses what you need. And that's for a reason, right? Because whoever made that video really understands their target audience and they have the keywords to go with it, which is how you saw it. And more than likely, it also means that the content is useful to you. So there is a reason why we do these things. Our blogs also typically include some form of biography at some point as well, some background information on them. But typically month to month, after the initial start, we're going for specific things addressing our prospects' problems. And this one in particular, I'm just going to point this out real quick, the stress-free travel planning tips. This came up from a conversation with him. We like to have frequent conversations with our clients just to know from their perspective, what are they seeing? How are they feeling about the business that they're getting? Ideas and things like that. There's only a certain amount of things you can kind of get through with an email or a text or a phone call these days, right? So we go through, we either meet in person or we do a video chat with our clients and we go over some of these things. And this came up often. When he was searching through social media in different places, he kept on seeing that travel was exciting, but also stressful for people. And I'll tell you personally, I 100% can relate to that. You know, a lot, most of you watching this, you're adults, you're busy, maybe you have families, you have careers, but you want to take that cruise. You want to go on that dream getaway. And planning it, or even thinking about taking the time off and all the logistical stuff, it can seem so stressful to the point where it kind of feels like it takes away from the experience, right? So giving information to our audience about how to make that process less stressful has been immensely valuable to them. This is just one piece of content about that. This is a blog that we made for him about this, but we made a whole series of social media posts about this topic, breaking it down individually. And it's gotten pretty good results so far, so we're really happy with that. And also, since his travel coaching services are brand spanking new, he's adding to his repertoire, adding to his service list, we made an announcement blog for that as well. And eventually we're going to do separate service pages for the website as well, which is all going to, you know, be SEO friendly, of course. All right, so let's go to his alignable page. So we also do consulting with him. Some of the content we do for him, some of it he does himself. So it's kind of like a hybrid approach, right? Some of it's coaching, some of it's do it yourself. So he will post frequently on his page. He'll do product and service updates. He'll get recommendations there, which adds to his credibility, his online reputation, right? So if we can admit, most of us here can admit, we live in a digital world, right? People are just very much glued to their smartphones, whether we like it or not. So nowadays, the proof, right, of product or service, right, the proof that you can actually do what you say you do, it's not necessarily who your neighbor thinks is good or a family member thinks is good. Maybe, but it just depends. It really comes down to what people are saying about you online, right? And I know some of you say, well, I've heard that you can buy bots to do fake whatever. They cut down on that so many years ago. And it's also pretty obvious when you have a fake or manufactured review. A lot of people have gotten in trouble for that. Then they've gotten their Google accounts taken down, for example. If your Google account gets taken down, you essentially don't have a business these days. And it is not something to trifle with. So I highly recommend getting actual legitimate reviews for sure. But at any rate, this is another vehicle for social proof for him, just having these recommendations there. And most of them were given freely by his clients without even being prompted to, because he gives such good service. But if you're one of those people who, and I understand, who's a little shy about asking for reviews or asking for things in return, we can always coach you through it. The important part is we have some social proof here to show our future clients. And let's look at his Facebook profile as well. So he has a personal Facebook. He doesn't keep up with that as much. The alignable page is kind of more like a personal Facebook to him, if that makes sense. Like, that's where most of his regular interactions are, as far as what he does. His Facebook business page, however, is often managed by us. We kind of periodically add updates, things like that. We did all the optimization for the profile, all the back end stuff. So another thing to keep in mind with social media, you might not know this, you need to do a lot of optimization on the back end for your pages. It's not enough just to have your name there or what have you. You really need to update that on the back end. So we do those updates for him periodically. We create content for him, all that good stuff, like you see there. And yeah, it helps that he's gotten a few professional photo shoots as well. It makes it easier to do content for him, because the quality of the images we get is quality in, quality out, right? So that's another thing to keep in mind at home. Let's say you're working with a content creation company now, they're probably gonna have this conversation with you. Always make sure that you take high resolution photos and videos, nothing that's blurry or hard to see, because it makes that editing process more difficult. and could mean that something is rendered unusable, right? But you know, we're in good standing with that. He gives us really good content. And we have a stock photo library that we also use to get content as well. And that's besides the stuff that he'll take on his travels, his personal travels. We use Envato for that. Unsplash is another one. There's a few others I think I'm forgetting, but Envato Elements, I highly recommend it, guys. That is the main stock photo website that we use for the business. And if I were you, I would try it out for a month, but then by the year, you're going to save yourself a little bit of money and you're going to have access to millions of creative assets that they continue to update every single week, every single month, something like that. And I can attest to the quality of it and that they do in fact do frequent updates. It's just a great, great thing to have. Okay. So that covers my spiel about James Carpenter Travel. I again went into his website, our methodology for how we advertise his products and services, some new things that we have coming up, which is really exciting. If you're watching this video now, it's going to come out a few weeks from when I'm talking about this. So by then we'll have some idea about how his new services are doing online. Maybe we could do a follow-up video if you guys want to see it. If there's anything that maybe we didn't cover that you'd like to see or you have any questions, make sure that you comment below. And again, we would really appreciate hitting that like and subscribe button. Thank you so much. All right. See you soon. Bye-bye.